But YouTube isn't the only politicized part of Google. In an internal memo that written by Google revealed by James Damore's lawsuit, managers are told to avoid rewarding people for following the dominant, quote, white male culture of America. Aspects of that culture, the memo said, included the meritocracy, belief in objectivity, and individual achievement. Ideas that nobody thought were race specific until now. Harmeet Dhillon is representing James Damore in this lawsuit. She joins us tonight. It's hard to believe this is even real. Tell us what the memo says.
Yeah, so the memo basically says it's part of a Google program for managers called Inclusive Perf, which is inclusive performance, and they are coached and sometimes forced to evaluate people on managers on the feedback they give to their employees. So this memo is about when you give feedback to your employees, be careful not to give too positive feedback to white people for stuff that is white, according to Google, such as merit-based performance and individual excellence and so forth. And then, you know, when you're giving feedback to people of color, you should be sensitive to the fact that they're more likely to be in favor of group achievement and collective values. There's some negative traits associated with whites, which is supposed to be that they talk about you instead of to you, you know, so they're backstabbing. There are these gross racial stereotypes on both sides that are deeply offensive. For example, to say that this stereotype that whites care about meritocracy and accomplishment is to imply that other races don't. I mean, so this is clearly absurd. And the most absurd thing is that James Damore purportedly, after the fact, was let go because of gender stereotypes. But Google perpetuates racial stereotypes every single day in its management. It's shocking.
But they don't, of course, hold their, I don't know, programming staff to these same standards. I mean, no. Of course, they demand excellence when it comes to writing the code that is the basis of their business.
Right, of course they should.
Right, yeah, of course, as they should, by the way. I agree with that. So what's their response been? I mean, this seems horrifying, incredibly divisive, inherently bigoted, as you just pointed out. Are they conceding this is real?
No, I don't think they get it. I mean, Google is too big to fail, too powerful to be questioned. And so they've been getting away with this. And in fact, in the face of our lawsuit, they simply describe all criticism of their race baiting and racial gerrymandering as alt-right criticism.
You and I had the same job 25 years ago. You've been a conservative your whole life. You're on the Dartmouth Review 30 years ago. Why are conservatives, Republicans in Washington defending this crap, defending Google? Why aren't they doing something about this?
Well, I'm afraid one very crass reason is that Google spreads the money around both sides. So members of Congress and the Senate who have power to do something about antitrust issues, these gross employment violations, they don't care. It's hard to get their attention. And, you know, Google very carefully spreads the money around in the media as well, and in nonprofits as well. I mean, they're really ubiquitous and everywhere. And so as a result, people know which side their bread is buttered. And there are very few principled people who say, you know, I don't want to take your money, Google. I'm going to criticize you, and I'm going to be objective about it. So that's what we're running up against here in this case. Now, there are a lot of patriots who are shocked by this. I mean, we've had the recent example just this week of Google trying to seal our lawsuit. In fact, they have sealed it for a two-month period, believe it or not. They called up the court, and they said, you know, some of our employees are being harassed. We want to bring a motion to seal this entire lawsuit. And the court has sealed it for 2 months. So for 2 months now, the public is not going to be able to go to the Santa Clara County Superior Court and read that. But where's the outrage? Nobody seems to care.
Well, it's on this show. Thank you for all you're doing. Harmeet
Dhillon,
thank you.
Thanks for having me.